Hello and welcome to this Dell PowerProtect Data Manager Appliance video showcasing how to configure physical network separation. Network separation allows the user to have a physically dedicated network connection that can be used for various purposes, including replication traffic or cloud use cases. The PowerProtect DM5500 is an integrated data protection appliance that offers powerful and secure protection of modern workloads, all designed with the end user in mind, with ease of use and one user interface. The DM5500 also has flexible and reliable upgrades, health monitoring and reporting, and a single license model based on back-end usable capacity, from 12 terabytes to 96 terabytes in 12 terabyte increments. The prerequisites for configuring physical network separation are having either available NIC ports on PCIe port 4 or using an available NIC card in PCIe slot 3. PCIe slots 1 and 4 are used during the initial deployment. Also, the uplinks from the ports must be plugged in to the configured ports on the customer's switch. After entering the appliance management IP, the main login screen appears. Using a Chrome browser, we'll log in as admin and use the password that was set during the initial deployment. On the appliance dashboard, to start the network separation, we select Infrastructure, then Networks. On the network screen, we select the Uplinks tab and click Add to add a new uplink group. In the dialog, we enter the group name, select the available uplinks, then select Save. When the uplink group is added and is in the ready state, select the network tab. Click Add, then enter a network name of your choosing. Select the VLAN ID and the uplink group, then enter the subnet mask and the data IP address. One or two data IPs are supported. Click Next. On the summary page, there are no routes listed because routes are not required for backup and replication. After verifying the details here, we click Apply. On the Networks page, we see that the network status is in progress. When the network configuration is complete, the status changes to Ready. This network is for backups, but a similar network could also be used for replication or cloud use cases. The physical network separation is now configured with the new uplinks and network and data IPs. At this point, we can add a protection policy by selecting Protection, then Protection Policies. On the Add Policy page, we specify the policy name, its purposes, its assets, and its objectives. By selecting Add here, we can select the newly created network interface and specify the backup and retention details. By selecting View Details, we can display and monitor the policy configuration jobs until they complete. We're now ready to execute a backup. To do this, we select Protection, then Protection Policies. On this page, we select the policy, then click Protect Now to start the backup. When the backup has started, select View Details to monitor the protection job. To see more details, we select the job ID, then the details hyperlink. When the protection job has succeeded, it verifies that the newly added network is functioning as designed. This concludes the physical network separation video. To get more information about the PowerProtect DM5500, please check out these links for additional resources such as white papers, videos, and other resources. Thanks for watching.